Hey there, guys, and welcome. My name is Rick Utzer here with AirgunWeb, where we tell you the facts, not fluff, and we bring you the old school airgun reviews. Today's video is brought to you by UmarexUSA, and we're going to take a look at the Walther Reign. This is a pretty affordable bullpup made in Germany, just a really nice gun. Let's get into it. So if you guys watch my channel, you know something about me. I don't like bullpups. I don't like them. I've tried to like them. I've worked really hard to try and like them, but I don't like them. And it's basically because for me, the center of gravity is just off and it goofs me up and I don't like them. But the Walther Reign, even when I tried this, like, oh gosh, I don't know when I tried the first one. It might've been a year ago. It actually is the one, well, one of the bullpups I actually do like. I mean, generally I hate them, but this one, they've done something with this to make this shootable for me. So let's go through all the specs and I'll kind of walk through why I like this gun so much and why, even though some things on paper, you scratch your head, it needs this or it needs that. I think it's beautiful just the way it is. And so let me sort of explain that to you. All right, so the Walther Reign is not regulated. And I know, like, immediately people go, it needs to be regulated. Well, yes and no. I don't think it needs to be regulated. If you know where you need to be in your shot curve, then you actually get some really good results without the need of a regulator. We'll get to that here in a little bit. It is very lightweight and compact, and I love the form factor. I love that the bottle is hidden. I love the fact that it looks, I don't know, it just looks good to me. This gun, to me, looks really, really nice. The way they've brought the cocking lever up here, it's got a really nice cocking action. It's not hard to cock. It's not hard to set it back. It's just very, very comfortable. You can take this while shooting and actually run the system and never take your face off your scope. To me, I like the way they've done this. Now, I also really love the way they've done the magazine. So not only is it this cool little mag that's ambidextrous, it comes from this side or this side or this side, but just the neat features. This is what you get with German engineering. There's a little door here. So when you go to drop your first pellet in, there's a door that stops it from falling out, and that door opens when you seat the mag. I mean, that's that little thing, that little extra that you get with a German engineered air gun. And this is made in Germany. Just real quick, let's talk about price point just for a second. It's $600. So, you know, you're getting a German air gun built German quality for $600. For me, there's a lot going on there that makes me happy, okay? So let's talk about shot count. If you take it to a full fill, which is 232 bar, you're gonna get a lot of shots, well over 60, easy. Now you will have a hell of a shot curve, and I need my phone. So I did just a long shot string of this gun starting from 232 bar until I saw it fall off, really fall off the valve. So, right when you start out, it's like you think, oh my gosh, this thing's anemic. It only was shooting 675 feet per second. That's because it was sort of valve locked, I guess, at the upper pressure. But after you got into like the second and third mag, then you started to see it really open up. And really right around shot, I'd say 27, say from there until the end, which is, you're looking at about three mags, really. You had some really good velocities. You're pushing, this is in 25 cal, we're pushing 38 foot-pounds out of this little gun, which is impressive to me. I think that's really good for something that's not about power. It's really about form factor, the shooting experience, and accuracy, which we'll get to here in a minute here. Okay, so we topped out at 39 foot-pounds at shot, because actually, I take that back. We topped out at 43 foot-pounds at 878. So with those three mags in the pressure curve, and I'll tell you what those pressures are here in a second, at least in my gun, you're going to have about a 50 foot per second spread. So it's going to kind of do this number and then go back down. If you live there at 50 yards, that difference in velocity isn't going to matter. Now, if you're trying to shoot accurately at 100 yards, it will matter. And so for there, there's about two mags, say, let's call it 18 shots, that have very little spread. If you know where you are, where you need to be in your pressure to be in that kind of start there, then you're going to be in good shape. Let me just kind of walk through what we got pressure-wise so that you guys have that information. So, you know, I shot from 232 down to 100 bar, and really we started hitting our stride at about 165 bar, and probably right around about 130, 120 bar, we started to see us kind of fall off. And at 100 bar, we were really going to drop fast. So you can get, you know, those three, maybe four mags out of this that are going to be really accurate at, say, 50 yards. And now, if you're shooting in your backyard at 35 yards, it won't matter. Just, you know, I would probably wouldn't fill it to 232. I'd maybe fill to 200 and shoot five mags. That's probably what I would do and have fun. All right, so let's go ahead and talk about a couple of the other, you know, numbers that I know you guys want to know. Let's talk about noise. First of all, it's about 106 dB. It kind of lives in that area. That seems to be about what we're getting out of these types of guns. I don't see that we're able to do anything with the integrated moderator, so you sort of get what you get. I don't find it that loud. I would have probably, as long as I have a silent pellet trap to shoot into, I would have shot this back in Havasu without a problem, because I think once you get just, you know, 20, 30 yards away, I think that noise really just falls off. On the trigger pull, you're looking at right around 2 pounds. So anywhere from 1 pound, 14, 15 ounces to 2 pounds, 1 ounce, it's right in there. Very predictable two-stage trigger. I like the trigger. Again, going back to the cocking effort, it's super easy and super convenient. The balance of the gun is really what sold me. A lot of times, the bullpups, they take this rail and they're trying to get your scope right down to the bore, which I understand, but when your cheek is level with the bore, man, that means you got to crane your neck to try and make the gun fit well. That bugs me. I can't stand it, but they did a really good job here by having a high enough rail. And then I'm using a Hawk. This is called the Air Max Touch, which I'm able to just drive my eye right up against this little cup, and I don't have to worry about eye relief. So I can get just lock in and get super comfortable, and I'm able to shoot the gun very well. So let's talk about the shooting results. So I was going to try some different pellets, but when I saw the crony numbers, I said this is really tailor-made for the JSB King. So that's what I stuck to in this review. I did, just for giggles, try and shoot some of the Mark II. As you can see, yeah, those weren't going to shoot well. So I just, instead of wasting pellets, I stopped. So the one thing with a bullpup, and this is one of the things I find is challenging with them, but with this one, I'm willing to put in the work to overcome it, is, as you see here, we have two very different groups, right? So this was my first group, and if you watch me on the bench, you'll see I've sort of got the gun, it's sort of up a little bit higher. I'm not really locked in and rested well. The gun has the opportunity to sort of move around, which means you either have to be really good on controlled with your follow through, or maybe change how you're shooting and lock the gun down a little bit better, and that is the difference. So from here, poor technique, to here, better technique, and you can see the gun's a shooter. The gun will absolutely shoot very, very well. What I noticed about this group here is that every time my shot would end, wherever my follow through was is where the pellet went. So when I controlled my follow through, I shot fine. I shot more like this. But when I didn't, you can see how it just wandered everywhere. And I could just watch as I would move or just wiggle a little bit. I'd watch, and wherever my scope ended, that's where the pellet was going. So the gun is very accurate. It does require you as the shooter to have good technique, a decent bipod, a nice, you know, rear rest, kind of lock everything in, and really kind of control your follow through, you're going to get some really good results. Now, if you know your shot curve, okay, so you need a chronograph, shoot a whole string, you're going to find in that string where the shots don't change much. Write down your pressure every time you change the mag out. You find that spot, then you know, okay, I'm going to fill to 165 bar. I got three mags. I'm good to go. So if you do that, this gun will really produce for you. It is one of the bullpups that I enjoy shooting. I don't know why I like this one so much, but I've had that relationship with a couple Walther guns now, and for whatever reason, maybe it's because I'm half German, I don't know, maybe that's it, it's some sort of genetic connection, but I like this kind of gun. I like the feel of it, I like the organic nature of it, I like the fact that it's not regged, I like that it's just simple, put the thing in and shoot and have fun, but at a shooting experience level that is a higher quality than you get and maybe, you know, something that's not as well built. I don't know how else to put it. So great gun, very well built, German quality, very good accuracy as long as you're doing your part. Shot count's really good for plinking. It's good for hunting if you want to do that too. Just mind your shot curve. Trigger pull is good. Everything about this, you know, it's the bullpup that I really like. Price point's great too. So if you want to know more about this gun, it's easy. Go to www.umarexusa.com. Look it up. It's available in other calibers as well. I'd like to get the 22 maybe and try that out again. But I, you know, the 25 shooting really well for me. So maybe I'm going to just stick with this one. Guys, that's going to be it for now. My name is Rick Huster here with Airgun Web. We tell you the facts, not fluff. You're home for old school airgun reviews. Thanks for watching.